I'm Laura. We'll be doing a gentle flow and restore class today. So go ahead and get started on your back. And today for class, we'll need props, a bolster, folded up blanket, or similar sized pillow, and a couple of blocks as well. We're going to start on our back and then take your block. You can also use a pillow, a bolster, anything that will just have some solid support. Set up your feet and knees about hip distance apart and have your arms rested alongside the body, block or prop within reach, and then press into your arms and feet to lift your hips up. And take your block underneath the hips, right underneath the sacrum, very low part of the spine. And let your hips rest right on top of the block or whatever props that you have, and let your hips rest heavy down onto that prop. Let your eyes relax closed. And today we'll start with the hands grounded onto the body. So you can place the hands onto the hips or onto the belly. Feel free to let your eyes relax closed. Just feel the back of the head and neck relaxed, feel the shoulders relaxed, face is soft. And take the first few moments just settling the weight of the body down towards the earth. We'll take a full breath in through the nose and through the mouth, let it go. Again, full breath in, expanding through the lungs, and sigh it out through the mouth, let it go. And one more breath like that, full breath in through the nose, and sigh it out through the mouth, let it go. And just a few more breaths. You can take your arms out to a T or bend your elbows out to the sides. Just feel a little bit more opening across the chest and shoulders. And allow your breath to be back to its natural pace. Just let it travel in and out through the body at its own pace. And just start to notice in your physical body if there are areas of tension or tightness or anything that might need a little bit more care or attention. And see if you can just breathe into those spaces. Allow them to feel heavy and settled and supported by the earth. If you'd like to take a moment to create an intention for your practice, feel free to set one. Any positive thought for yourself or for anyone else who might need it. And take another full breath in. And sigh out through the mouth, let it go. Just bring your arms back down along the side of the body. Press into the arms, press into the feet to gently lift the hips up. Keep your hips lifted as you move your block or prop out from underneath you. And then with control, softly roll down the spine, vertebrae by vertebrae, gently lowering your hips all the way back down onto the earth. And stay onto your back. Take your right leg up towards the sky. Flex your foot so you're pulling the toes back towards your shin. And then point the toes, stretching the top of the foot. And just do that two more times, flexing the foot and then pointing the toes. One more time, flexing the foot and then pointing the toes. And keep your toes pointing up towards the sky and draw little circles with your toes, just getting movement into the right hip. You can feel the quad, the big muscle on top of the thigh engage. Make sure you're breathing and then just circle in the opposite way and feel the difference. Just depending on which direction you started, you might feel different muscles in the leg working in a different way. And let your leg come back to stillness. And then flex your foot again. So pull the toes back towards your shin. Take your hands behind your thigh to draw the leg closer, or maybe if you have the flexibility around the calf or closer towards the ankle. And then gently start to release. Plant your right foot back down. Extend your left leg up towards the sky. Flex your foot. Toes are pulling back. And then pointing your toes, stretching the top of the foot. And do that a couple more times, flexing and then pointing the toes. One more time, flexing the foot and pointing the toes up towards the sky. Keep your toes pointed, so still engaged through the entire leg. Circle your left leg around. Slow circles, just feeling the movement in the hip joint. And then go in the opposite way. And then let your leg be still, flex through your foot. And again, using the hands to help you draw behind the leg to bring your left leg closer towards the body, keeping your head, neck, and shoulders relaxed down. And then rest your left foot back down onto the ground. Reach your arms back behind you, just stretching back through the arms. Gently roll over to one side and use your hands and arms to press yourself up to seated. And we'll shift forward into a tabletop position. Wrists are underneath the shoulders, knees are underneath the hips. And start with a few rounds of cat and cow, inhaling to draw the heart forward. And exhaling to press into the palms and round the spine up. And just do that a few more times, moving through cat cow, and gently stretching through the spine. And coming back to neutral, take a moment to stretch your wrist. So flip your right palm over. Fingers point back towards the knee. Keep spreading through the fingers wide, stretching the top of the wrist. And you can gently rock side to side here if that feels okay. And then switch sides. Point your right fingertips back forward. Flip your left palm over. And again, you can stay right here. You might gently rock side to side. And point your left fingertips forward. Scoop both of your hands just a little bit forward of the shoulder, spreading through the fingers and pressing down into the palms. Tuck your toes, lift the hips all the way up and back into downward dog. Relax your head and neck between the arms. And then feel free to pedal your feet out for a moment, bending your knees one at a time. Feel the stretch into the calves. And then finding stillness, keep your head and neck relaxed between the arms. And start to gently walk your feet all the way forward up towards the hands, coming up to a forward fold at the top of our space. Rise up halfway with a flat spine. Bring your fingertips to the shins or the knees as you draw the heart forward. Exhale and fold it back down. And bend your knees. Let your head, neck, and arms stay heavy as you slowly rise up. Keeping your head, neck, and arms heavy, your legs will start to straighten. You'll start to stack vertebrae on top of vertebrae, standing all the way up tall. And turn your palms to face forward, spreading through the fingers wide. Circle your arms out and around with an inhale. Touch your palms overhead. And then as you exhale, bring your hands to the heart space. And two more circles with the arms. Inhale, sweeping the arms up. Exhale, hands to the heart space. And one more with the breath, sweeping the arms up. And exhale, hands to the heart space. And balance on your right foot. And lift your left knee about to the level of your hip and flex through the left foot. And take an inhale here. And as you exhale, bend into your right knee. So both knees are bent, both feet are flexed. And so press your right leg straight, keep your left knee bent. And then bend into your right knee again. Just one more time, pressing your right leg straight, and then bend into your right knee. Now press your right leg straight and press your left leg straight. Keep your foot flexed. Toes are pulling back towards the shin. Keep your tall spine. And while standing up tall, can you lift this left leg a little bit higher? And then set it down to the mat. Inhale, sweeping your arms up. Exhale, fold forward all the way down to your mat. Rise up halfway. Exhale and fold. And then walk your feet all the way back into your downward dog. Keep the hips lifted up high. Pressing into the palms. Grounded through the hands and feet. And then walk your hands back towards your feet without letting your hands drag. Come to a forward fold at the back of our space. Rise up halfway. Exhale, fold it back down. And rise all the way to standing, sweeping arms up, touching palms overhead at the top of the breath. Exhale, hands to the heart space. And now keep your balance on your left foot. Bend your right knee about to the level of the hip, keeping your foot flexed. Take an inhale breath here. Exhale, bend into your left knee. Inhale, press your left leg straight. Exhale, bend into the left knee. One more. Pressing the leg straight, bending into the knee. Stand tall into your left leg. Press your right leg straight, keeping your foot flexed. Toes are drawing back. Chest is open, tall spine. Take one more inhale. Maybe you can lift your right leg a little bit higher. And then step your right foot down onto the ground. Inhale, just sweep the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Rise up halfway. Exhale and fold back down. And come all the way way to standing, sweeping arms up, touching palms overhead at the top of the breath. Exhale, hands to heart space. Two more half salutations, sweeping the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Rise up halfway. Exhale and fold. And rise all the way to stand, sweeping arms up, touching palms overhead at the top. Exhale, hands to heart space. And one more with the breath, sweeping the arms up. Exhale, fold it forward. Rise up halfway. Exhale and fold. And all the way up to standing, sweeping your arms up, touching palms overhead at the top of the breath. And exhaling hands to the heart. Bend your knees, get your hips back into your chair pose, and just make sure your feet are parallel. Toes are all pointing forward. You can have them about hip distance apart. Keep your knees about hip distance apart as well. Feel the legs working here. Relax the shoulders. Engage the core. And press into your feet. Rise all the way up to standing. Touch your palms overhead. And exhale, bring your hands to the heart space. And from here, bend your knees. Sit your hips down low. Sweep your arms up. Chair pose just for the breath. Exhale and fold it forward. Rise up halfway. Exhale and fold. And then walk it forward into your downward dog. Pressing the hips all the way up and back. Shift forward, shoulders over your wrists into plank position. You can always use your knees to help support you. We're gonna slowly lower all the way to the belly. Keep your elbows hugging in. Lower down nice and slow. Point your toes back. Bring your hands by your lower ribs. Press into the feet, inhale, rise to cobra. Keep the neck relaxed as you lift the chest using the back muscles. Gently release back down. Two more with the breath, lifting up. Gently release. And one more with the breath, lifting up, and gently release back down. Rise up through the hands and knees, tuck your toes, lift your hips all the way up and back into your downward dog. And start to walk your feet all the way forward up to your hands, coming up to a forward fold at the top of our space. Rise up halfway. Exhale, fold it back down. And rise all the way up to standing, sweeping your arms up, touching your palms overhead. And exhale, bring your hands to the heart. Inhale, sweep your arms up, and exhale, fold it forward, rise up halfway, and as you exhale, fold back down, keep your right foot in front, and take a big step back with your left foot, keep your left foot a little bit out towards the left, keep your back heel lifted, rise up to high crescent, lifting your chest and your arms all the way up towards the sky, and feel a stretch into the front of your left hip, relax the shoulders, reach energy up through the fingertips, and steady breaths here, take one more inhale breath. And as you exhale, turn your chest towards the left and spin your back heel down. Take your arms up to a T. So your right knee is still staying bent over your right heel. Back leg is straight, sealing the outer edge of your back foot down. Flip your right palm up. Inhale, reach it back to reverse warrior. Legs stay the same, chest and arms reach back. And circle your hands all the way down to the mat. Take a big step forward to the top of our space and rise up halfway. Exhale, fold it back down, all the way to stand, sweeping arms up, touching palms overhead at the top. Exhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, sweeping the arms up. Exhale, fold it forward. Rise up halfway. Exhale and fold, and now keep your left foot in front. Take a big step back with your right foot. Keep your back heel lifted up. Rise facing forward to your high crescent. And pause here, shoulders stacked over the hips. Fingertips reach up, palms facing towards each other. Shoulders are nice and soft. One more inhale breath. And then as you exhale, spin your back heel down. Turn your chest to the right, warrior two, floating the arms out to a T. Steady breaths, opening up across the chest. Flip your left palm to face up. Reach it back to reverse warrior. Take one more inhale breath. And exhale, take your hands down. Step it back to your downward dog, pressing the hips all the way up and back. Inhale, shift forward to plank. You can use your knees if needed. Slowly lower all the way to the belly, keeping your elbows close to the body. Toes point back. Rise to cobra, pressing into the feet, lifting through the heart space. Exhale, float it back down. Press up through your hands and knees. Tuck your toes, lift your hips all the way up and back into your downward dog. Walk your feet all the way up to your hands, back to your forward fold at the top. Rise up halfway. Exhale, fold it back down. All the way to stand, sweeping arms up, touching palms overhead at the top of the breath. Exhale, hands. And we'll do that another round. Inhale, sweeping the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Rise up halfway. Exhale and fold. Keep your right foot in front. Take a big step back with your left foot. Rise on your inhale, high crescent. Exhale, open up, warrior two, spinning your back heel down. Flip your right palm up. Inhale, reach it back to reverse warrior. Exhale, hands to the earth. And just take a big step forward to the top of our space. Rise up halfway. Exhale, fold. Rise to standing, sweeping our arms up, touching palms overhead. Exhale, hands to the heart. Inhale, sweeping the arms up. Exhale, folding forward. Rise up halfway. Exhale and fold. Now keep your left foot in front. Big step back with your right foot. Rising up to your high crescent, lifting up through the fingertips. Spin your back heel down, open it up to your warrior two. Inhale, reach it back to reverse warrior. And then exhale, hands to the mat. This time, step it back to your downward dog, pressing the hips up and back. And once again, shift forward to plank. You can use your knees as you slowly lower all the way down. And toes point back, rise to cobra or upward dog if that's part of your practice. And tuck your toes, lift all the way up and back into your downward dog. And steady breaths here, grounded through the hands and feet. Full breath in through the nose. And sigh it out through the mouth, let it go. Walk your feet all the way forward up to the hands. Rise up halfway and exhale and fold it back down. We're going to rise to standing, sweeping your arms up, touching palms overhead at the top of the breath. Exhale, hands to heart space. Back to chair pose, bending your knees, sitting your hips down low. And start with your hands at the heart space. Steady breaths. And if you want to challenge the shoulders and the arms a bit more, reach your arms up alongside the ears or even slightly forward of the ears is fine. Palms face towards each other, relax the shoulders. See if you can sit down deeper, still staying steady with the breath. Take an inhale. Exhale, try to sit down lower. See if you can touch the ground to the outsides of the feet. Inhale, arms and chest lift back up. Two more times, sweeping the fingertips down. Inhale and lift. One more time, sweeping the fingertips down. Inhale, lifting up. And then exhale and folding forward. Relax everything down. Rise up halfway. Exhale and fold. Walk your feet back to your downward dog. And just breathe. Feel the length through the spine, the extension through the arms and through the backs of the legs. Let the head and neck feel relaxed between the shoulders. Full breath in. Through the mouth, let it go. And gently lower your knees down. Shift your hips back towards your heels. And we're going to use our bolster and possibly blocks for our first restorative pose. So you'll take your bolster behind your hips, horizontally across the mat. And you may or you may not like to use your blocks to bring your feet together and open the knees out towards the sides for a little bit of support. So just have the bolster horizontally across the mat right behind your hips. And you'll start to gently rest your spine on top of the bolster. Reach your arms out to the sides, up to a T, or bend your elbows if that feels comfortable. And the bolster or whatever prop you're using is going to emphasize the curve of the spine in the mid lower back. And the arms should rest just right at the top edge of the bolster. You can be out straight with the palms facing up, or you can bend your elbows. If it's too intense for your knees to be open up to the sides, you can always rest with your knees bent up instead. And feel free to let your eyes relax closed. And just staying with the breath, full breaths in and out. And let this lift underneath the back. You can feel how on your inhale it might feel a little bit constricted. See if you can find that full lung capacity, full breaths filling up the lungs, and slowly letting everything release. In our restorative practice, we aim to let everything feel relaxed and grounded towards the just notice if anything in your body is straining. If you need to make a little adjustment to release and relax the body a little bit more, you can feel free to do that. You want to feel fully supported and fully rested. And once you feel nice and comfortable, just allow yourself to rest. You can continue to be mindful of the breath traveling in and out of the body. You can focus on your intention. You can allow this to be a meditative practice. Take a few more full, deep, mindful breaths here. You can use your hands to help you gently bend your knees up and plant your feet down onto the mat. Grounded through the feet, reach your arms all the way back behind you. Find that little stretch, you're going to keep the bolster as it is, and then roll over onto your right side. You might need to readjust a little bit. Want the bolster to be right about at the top of the right hip. You're going to rest your right side of your waist on top of the bolster. So it's this version of a fetal position with the bolster underneath the right side waist. Rest your right your head into your upper right arm. And your left arm can relax on top of the side body or in front of the belly or behind your back, gently letting it wrap into the shoulder. Some of you might find it comfortable to reach your left arm alongside the ear and let your palms gently touch. That will help to create more stretch onto the left side ribs. And again, just check in, make sure your body feels really comfortable here. Relax your head and neck. Let your face soften. You're always welcome to let your eyes relax closed. You can let your belly be soft. Allow yourself to surrender effort and drop into that sense of ease and relaxation. gently deepen your breath. Pull your breath in and out. Without feeling like you're being rushed, or without any sense of haste or hurry, gently press your left hand into the mat. And press your right hand into the mat to lift yourself up towards seated. You're going to twist your knees over towards the left side. Come into that version of a fetal position, supported by the bolster underneath the left side waist. So you can extend your left arm all the way out. Press your left side of the head on top of the left arm. You can reach your right arm on top of the side body, in front or behind the body. Or you might reach it up and overhead. Getting that stretch into the right side ribs. Again, here as you settle in on this side, can you relax your head and neck into the upper left arm. Feel everything resting soft towards the earth. Again, here, gently start to deepen your breath without feeling rushed or hurried out of this pose. Just become more aware of your body again. And then gently start to get out of it, pressing into your right palm, into your left palm. Use your hands and arms to support you coming up. And we'll set up for our final resting pose, Shavasana. So you can take your most comfortable pose, feel free to use your props. If you're at home and possibly near a couch or a bed, I'll show you one pose that's really comfy. I'm gonna do that for my Shavasana. You'll bring your hips close to the edge of the couch or bed. And then take your knees up onto the corner edge. Use your hands and arms to let yourself relax down. And you can rest with your hands gently onto the body, or you can move the arms away from the body. Feel free to let your eyes relax closed. And before our deepest rest, just taking a full breath together here. Big inhale through the nose. And letting it all go through the mouth. allow yourself to receive all the nurturing benefits of this gentle practice. And thank yourself for valuing a slower pace. Let your eyes relax back, feel your jaw relax. Face is soft, shoulders heavy, belly soft, hips heavy. Just relax all the way down through the arms, into the fingers, and all the way down through the legs, into the toes. If you have the time, you're welcome to stay in Shavasana for as long as you'd like. Even if you drift off to sleep, it's totally fine letting your body fully take in these moments of rest. And if you're ready to close up your practice, take a fuller breath in and out. Feel the breath gently reawakening the body. And then on your next inhale, start to reach your arms back behind you and gently roll over into a fetal position onto one side. Your favorite side, let your head rest into the upper arm, let your knees be drawn into the chest. And just letting yourself feel grounded here. And we'll close together in this pose, so just bring your awareness back to your intention. Feel gratitude for your body. Thank yourself for valuing rest and relaxation. And we'll close with one more full breath in through the nose and sigh out through the mouth. Let it go. Thank you so much for sharing your practice with me today. Namaste.